Welcome to an example on how to find the partial fraction decomposition of a rational expression that contains repeated quadratic factors in the denominator. First, notice the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, which must be the case before we perform partial fraction decomposition. If it wasn't, we'd have to perform long division first. Notice the degree of the numerator is 3, and the degree of the denominator, if we multiply this out, would be 4. Also notice the denominator is already factored since x squared plus 2 does not factor again. So starting with the original rational expression, because we have two factors in our denominator which are repeated, we'll have two partial fractions here on the right. And again, because it's a repeated factor, our first fraction will have one factor of x squared plus 2, and the second fraction will have two factors of x squared plus 2. But because these are quadratic factors, the numerators could be linear factors, which means for this first fraction, we'll have a numerator of ax plus b. And for the second fraction, because they're also quadratic factors, we could possibly have another linear factor in the numerator, so we'll have cx plus d. Notice how we ended this expression with the variable b, so we start this expression with c. Now our main goal here is to find the values of a, b, c, and d, which will give us our partial fraction decomposition. So for the next step, we're going to clear the fractions from this equation by multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common denominator, which would be the quantity x squared plus 2 to the second power. Notice the left side simplifies nicely. X squared plus 2 squared over x squared plus 2 squared, that simplifies to 1, leaving us with 18x cubed plus 13x on the left side. And then on the right side, notice for this first product, one factor of x squared plus 2 simplifies out, which would leave us with the quantity ax plus b times the quantity x squared plus 2. And then for the second product, both factors of x squared plus 2 simplify out or simplify to 1, leaving us with cx plus d. This is called the basic equation, which we'll use to find the values of a, b, c, and d. And there are two main methods for doing this. One method is called equating the coefficients, and the second method, which we used in most of the previous videos, we select convenient values of x, which means values of x that would simplify out several of the terms, allowing us to find a, b, c, and d. But for this example, we're going to use equating the coefficients, which means we're going to start by multiplying out the right side and then grouping the like terms in terms of x next to each other to factor them. So let's go ahead and start with that. We have 8x to the third plus 13x. Now here we're going to have four products, 1, 2, 3, 4. Notice the first product would be ax cubed, and then we'll have 2ax, and then we'll have plus bx squared, and then plus 2b, and then we still have plus cx plus d. Now for this next step, we'll group the like terms in terms of x next to each other, which we'll then factor. So we have 8x cubed plus 13x. There's only one x cubed term, it's ax cubed. There's only one x squared term, that's plus bx squared. Notice how there are two x terms. We have 2ax and we also have cx. So we have plus 2ax plus cx. And there are two terms that don't have x's, 2b and d. So plus 2b plus d. And now we'll factor the x from these two terms and then match up the coefficients on the left side of the equation with the like terms. So to help us do this, I'm going to write 8x cubed plus 13x as 8x cubed plus 0x squared, which is still 0, plus 13x, and our constant would be 0, so we'll plus 0 here. So on the right side we'll have ax cubed plus bx squared. And now for these two terms I'll factor out the x. So we'll have plus the quantity 2a plus c times x plus, and I'm going to go ahead and just put these two terms in parentheses, 2b plus d. So now the method of equating the coefficients means if these two sides of the equation are equal to each other, then the coefficients of the like terms must be equal, which means if we have 8x cubed here, 8 must be equal to a. The coefficient of the x squared term is 0, which means 0 must be equal to b. The coefficient of the x term is 13, which means 13 must be equal to 2a plus c. And then finally on the left side, the constant is 0, which means 0 must equal 2b plus d. So knowing this information, we can now set up a system of equations to find a, b, c, and d. So again, let's start with a equals 8. Next, we know that b must equal 0. We also know that 2a plus c must equal 13. And 2b plus d must equal 0. So again, we already know a equals 8 and b equals 0. So using the third equation, 2a plus c equals 13, we can find c since we know a equals 8. We would have 2 times 8 plus c equals 13. Well, 2 times 8, of course, is 16. Subtracting 16 on both sides, we have c equals negative 3. And now for the last variable, d, if b is equal to 0, we'd have 2 times 0 plus d equals 0. So we also know d equals 0. Now that we know the values of a, b, c, and d, we know our partial fraction decomposition. We'll just substitute these values into our two fractions here. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. Since we know a is 8 and b is 0, for this first fraction we would have 8x plus 0, or just 8x. So we have 8x divided by the quantity x squared plus 2. And then for the second fraction where we have a numerator of cx plus d, notice c is negative 3 and d is 0, so this would be negative 3x. But instead of writing plus negative 3x over our denominator, we can go and just write minus 3x divided by our denominator. And this would be our partial fraction decomposition of the given rational expression. Which means if we were to subtract these two fractions, the difference would be the original rational expression. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.